happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to a new series. Today we are on Dakota Plains. This map was given to me by somebody. It's to be used on a server, but I'm also playing on it in single player. The map is private, and no, you will not get it. This is one of Random Sparks' maps. This is by far my favorite of his. But anyway, what we're going to do is we have a field that we need to cultivate. It's got like alfalfa or clover in it, and we have no use for that at the moment. So we're going to get that cultivated under. We're going to move some equipment first. I guess we can walk around it. There we have the case headers, a 25 foot and an 8 row, International 6200 grain drill, Hardy sprayer, Alice Chalmers 8030, Oliver 1955 with cab and then without cab. I did get permission to release these and I did send them to FSUK, but they found a couple of things that I'm going to fix and I just haven't fixed them yet and uploaded them. Again, but they will be released very in the near future. We have this little cultivator here. John Deere 7200, what is it? 12 row. We have two Chevy C70 grain trucks. This one is the single axle with dyeable cab, and then this is the one to match my grandpa's truck. And we have a 5130. So what we need to do is we need to move the Alice and the cabbed tractor. And then we do have a Thunder Creek fuel trailer. That is the trailer from FS17. It's dyeable as well. Pretty nice trailer. I might edit that Alice Chalmers to have the same sounds as this tractor does, because the ones that are on it right now kind of annoy me. They're kind of loud. Anyhow, we're gonna get hooked up here. Get this lifted up. So I have a $200,000 loan, and I'm down to $46,000. So I sold all of the equipment that it had on here to start with, and purchased all the equipment that you see here. And then also, you know, I took out the $200,000 loan. So I do want to go into the map and edit this so that these gates and these posts on the side of it don't have collision, because they're hard to not hit because they're so small. There are a few other farms that you can buy. You can buy this farm up here, which is a little bit larger of a farm, has bigger grain complexes and whatnot. And then you can also buy East River Angus, which is a giant beef farm. When I say giant, I mean giant. It is huge. And of course my battery is messing up in my mouse. So I'm recording this here on Thursday, and I'm going to be going to my first day of work today. I have training today, and sadly it's snowing and I gotta walk. I don't have any other way to get there right now. It's snowing, which kind of sucks. I'm sick of this snow. Anyway, we're gonna get this unfolded here. We're gonna get some stuff shut down. And we're gonna start putting this stuff under. hop out and take a picture. Sit here and put this stuff under. Kind of wish I had a bigger cultivator, but for starting out, this is what I got. I need to go do some searching and find some other cultivators. I really don't have that much for small ones. Definitely a very fast dirt skin on the cultivator there. Well, let's cultivate in first person a little bit, maybe. This will work. Yeah. So this is a very good-sized map. It's got a lot of different sizes of fields, which is really nice. Okay, there has got to be a bit of a different cultivator here. Yeah, but those are all 3-point. Maybe one of these. That one, maybe. I don't know. I'll use this for now, I guess, though. I thought this map had soil mod, but I guess it doesn't. I have soil mod in my mods folder, but nothing's happening, so. Alright, it's not showing up. So it must not. Battery, it just like keeps moving out of place. I don't know why. Might be getting close to time for a new battery. Okay, this is just getting ridiculous now. Might be getting time to put a new battery in it. I bought it almost a year ago and I haven't put a battery in it yet, so. Can't say that I wouldn't be surprised if it needs a battery. It's hard to tell what's what here. I think this is a field of alfalfa, is what this is. Okay, this is starting to get annoying here. I'll have to find some batteries here pretty quick. In fact, I may have some here somewhere. Triple A's, of course. Got some. Okay, we should be good to go now. Hopefully no more incidents with this battery here. What the world has got an offset? Dang it. I didn't want an offset. Okay, we're gonna flip it 90 degrees. We'll do these end rows here. This tractor definitely looks a lot nicer with a dirt skin on it. The cultivator is attached underneath. Didn't know that was possible. At least for that type of hitch. Or trailer, I mean, not hitch, but trailer. Oh. So we'll do four passes on each end here. And then we'll run that way. Oh, that's what I forgot to buy. I need to buy a pressure washer yet. As you can see our bins there. Let's put this right there by the shop. Alright, so we got one more here, and then we'll go and do the other side. Whoa. Oh, that's why. I need to slow this down a ways. As you can see, this thing definitely gets dirty. I didn't make the steering wheel, the steering column, any of the, well, I guess those ones did get dirty, but some of these other controls didn't get dirty. The gauges didn't get dirty. So we can go here. That wood didn't get dirty. Steering wheel, or seat. All that good stuff. I didn't have any of that get dirty, so... I mean, normally the entire tractor is dirty and, like, everything, inside and out. Okay. So we're just gonna cut this off here, this little bit, just to make it even. just gotta check my schedule here. Cause I see that I have an email saying it was updated. Okay, so then we can just leave this as is, because these other ones, these ones here are going to be just free-handed, since this is not an even corner. I like this grass texture. So this alfalfa isn't fully grown yet either. But I think I'm gonna put in some corn and beans. Let's just look here, see what we got for prices. What we got for prices on these? Cows, almost $1,000. Wow. So we got soybeans, we got sunflowers. Okay, so maybe we'll do soybeans and rye, since those two pay pretty well. So, soybeans and rye. This is the map that I'll probably be playing on now until my Eastern Dakota Farms map is done. Which it's getting there. I've got about half of the fields added. So, it's getting further along. There's still a lot of stuff to be done on it, but it's getting closer every day, thankfully. About halfway through. Right. See, I just finished getting all my stuff ready to go with me to work. Had to pack my work clothes, because I'm going to need all the thickness I can get when I walk in there. I don't think it's really that cold out, though, so shouldn't be too bad. I drive my truck, but not with the clutch being the way it is. Which I'll need to look, take a peek in my pickup before I leave and see if snow is getting in it. I don't know what direction the snow is coming from. It might be going in the little bend in my door. I would hope not, but it's happened before. I wish I could find a door with the exact same paint job. Or I know you can get it painted exactly the same, matching the fade and all that good stuff, but I'm not really that worried about it, that I'd want to go find a door and get it painted. Or even go find a door, period. I'm fine with it the way it is. In the summertime, it's a little bit of fresh air, I guess. And the wintertime, too, really. Ugh. I hate it when it does that. I do need to also update my graphics driver. I saw that earlier today that there's a update for it, so I hate when it does that. I should have turned a little bit wider there. Auto save. It's pretty expensive to buy the other farm. I think it's like 200,000 or 2 million or something like that. I don't remember exactly. I know there was a 2 and then a whole bunch of zeros, so I don't know if it was 200 or 2 million. But all I know, it's going to be a long time. Well, probably not a long, long time, but it's going to be a little while before that'll be in our reach. Probably a few growth seasons. I do also want to pick up some more fields down here. Maybe like field 30. Let's just see. What is the price of field 30? Field 30. $51,000. So I could take out a little bit more of a loan and we could buy it, but I'm not gonna do that. Maybe we'll buy it after this harvest season, because then we'll have more than enough. We can buy that field and pay off a little bit of loan. And I know you really wouldn't be using GPS with this tractor, but oh well, I guess. It looks like it quit snowing finally, which is nice. Another update. Guess we'll go in first person here for a little bit. So yeah, I don't know. I still haven't figured out what I'm gonna do with all the videos yet. If I'm going to be continuing the full, you know, daily uploads, or what I'm gonna do. I haven't decided, haven't figured it out yet. I don't know. I may just kind of upload here and there, maybe do like a couple times a week or something, or whatever. I have no idea at this moment. These Olivers are really, really nice tractors, though. I really like them. The creator did an awesome job on them. I forget that I have quick camera. And I could be snapping back and forth. Like that. So we've lost $4,000, I suppose, probably maintenance or something. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna do is end the video, because I still have a few things I gotta get done before I leave, and whatnot. So I'm just gonna end the video here. The next video we'll work on planting. We'll probably do whichever crop pays the most. It'll be in field 32, and then the other one will be here in 31. So yeah, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and we'll see you in the next video.